The very first and premier episode on this channel calls for a dish that I've had the fondest memories growing up as a child. It's my mother's roast chicken. So these are my mom's recipe books that I hold very, very close to my heart. As a child, I used to ditch my toys for my mom's pots and pans, creating quite a havoc in the kitchen, yet at the same time learning the finer traits and nuances of everyday cooking. Having honed my skills all across the globe, it comes back to getting down to the basics and learning how to create a roast chicken stuffed beautifully, but at the same time, putting in my skill set and taking it to the next level. Hey, I'm Jason, and let's get to creating gourmet food made easy. Although creating a roast chicken and having the entire beautiful bird on your table is extremely celebratory, at the same time, it forms great meals to enjoy either for a Saturday night dinner or for a Sunday. To start off with, we're going to ensure that our chicken is nice and dry. So have it wiped down dry with a lot of towel, kitchen towel. The drier the chicken, the more succulent the roast is, what my mom used to firmly believe. And I actually second that. To that, I'm going to take about a teaspoon of salt because I'm going to create the rub that goes into marinating the meat for at least 25 to 30 minutes. A teaspoon of salt, a teaspoon of freshly milled black pepper, 5 cloves of finely chopped garlic, 2 whole fresh green chilies finely chopped, along with some flat leaf parsley. So I've taken about a tablespoon of it. If you do not have any flat leaf parsley, you can also add some cilantro or fresh leaves of coriander to get the same
effect. All you need to ensure is that your chicken is about a kg to a kg 200 grams. They form the perfect roast. And you need to loosen the meat from the skin with your fingers. And this is how you end up flavoring the chicken breast, which is not really robust in flavor. So here goes the rub. You just mix it nicely and that goes straight inside and you smoothen it out right to the nooks and crannies under the skin. So while we put it up here on the breast, you ensure that the breast is nice and flavorful with the entire mix over here. A part of it goes in between the joints of the legs, push it right in. And another part goes on the other side in between the joints of the legs. Ensure that the skin covers the entire breast because that's what's going to keep the overall meat in this whole chicken moist. Put a little bit in the cavity below and you allow this to rest for about 15 to 20 minutes. And in the meantime, let's get to creating the beautiful stuffing that will go right into this cavity.
Now, to create the stuffing, I'm using readily available vegetables that everybody has in their kitchen. So I've taken about 2 carrots, finely diced it. I've taken about a handful of haricot beans or French beans, 1 red onion finely chopped, some ginger, some garlic, and some flat leaf parsley. Not forgetting 4 slices of bread, which I've cut into cubes because the bread is supremely important, because what really happens is once you stuff it into the chicken and as it roasts, the bread absorbs all the flavorful juices and liquid that runs clear from the chicken, creating quite a robust stuffing. Now to start off with, we're going to take 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. While I'm using extra virgin olive oil, you can actually go right ahead and use some cold pressed sunflower oil. You can also go splurge and use some butter. To start off with, I'm going to add ginger, and that's what's going to bring the heat to the entire stuffing. So about 1 tablespoon of finely chopped ginger, 6 cloves of garlic, finely chopped. And as that blooms into the oil, it's time to add in the red onion. So again, 1 large red onion finely chopped goes in. And we are going to allow this to get nice, soft, and beautifully translucent before we add in the carrots as well as the French beans.
When the onions get soft and translucent, it's time to throw in some sage, because sage and onion is a beautiful combination that works really well with roast chicken. However, if you do not have sage, any other herb can do. And it's time to add in the carrots. So about 2 carrots finely chopped into dices, they go in. Along with this goes in some, about 10 to 15 haricot beans or French beans, finely cut. Now you do not want to overcook this, so you're just going to saute it on a high fire till they are about 60% done, because you want the entire stuffing to cook along with the chicken and flavoring the entire meal.
Having stir-fried the carrots and the haricot beans for about 5 minutes, they're about 30-40% done. They've got a slight crunch to it. It's time now to season. So in goes some freshly milled beautiful black pepper. And while I'm adding black pepper, you can also go right in and add some nutmeg, because the flavors really take it to the next level. And a generous sprinkling of some sea salt, not too much because your chicken is heavily seasoned. Give this a good mix. We don't want to cook it more because we want the crunch to be there and we want the vegetables to actually roast along with the chicken in the cavity. So in goes 4 slices of bread. I'm using multigrain bread. You can use any bread. Cut them into about 1.5 centimeter diced and they go in. So they go in and you allow it to cook along with the vegetables, getting a slight crunch, but at the same time holding its shape. You do not want it to get a soggy, mushy mass. Cook this entire mix for about another 4 to 5 minutes. Cool it down and it's time to get it stuffed right into the chicken. Now with the chicken marinating for a good 30 minutes and the super tasty stuffing coming down to room temperature, it's time to stuff it into the cavity. So go right in with the fork, pushing it right into all the crevices of the cavity. And I always like to create extra stuffing because they form great add-ons to enjoy with your roast chicken. So in goes the stuffing. You can keep pushing it in so that it's nice and compressed. Now with the chicken nicely stuffed, and as you can see, the vegetables have gone right in. So technically you're supposed to stitch the cavity, but it can be quite a gruesome task. So I prefer to seal in the vegetables with some aluminium foil. And it retains the flavor, and at the same time, it also allows even heating of the entire mix. So now's the time to truss the chicken. While most often the chicken is trussed with a thread, I prefer using toothpicks. With the legs nicely trussed and held together with 2 toothpicks. You can also add a third one if you're unsure of whether they are holding fine. It's time to turn it and give the wings a slight knock so that they turn.
Here I'm holding the wings in play with yet another 2 to 3 toothpicks. And this is how a perfect roast chicken looks.
To ensure that the skin gets a nice crunch, it's time to give it a generous sprinkling of some sea salt, along with some freshly milled black pepper. Now, this is a trick that I learned while roasting chickens the world over. So whenever you roast a chicken, always roast it breast side down. So on my plate, I've got about 1 onion roughly chopped, a carrot roughly chopped, and some leeks, and that forms the basis of my mirepoix. They also form the bed so that the chicken doesn't stick to the roasting pan. Once you roast it breast side down, the fat from the backbone merges right down, keeping the breast nice and moist. To further ensure that it's a very moist chicken, I'm going to add about 1/4 cup of water into the roasting pan. Just a little so that it gives it the right amount of steam and forms the basis for the gravy as well. a generous sprinkling of some milk pepper back on top, and a generous sprinkling of some sea salt right on top. So with the chicken now going into a preheated oven at 200 degrees Celsius for about 40 minutes, I'm going to create the side that goes along with the roast chicken, and that's great wedges. So I've taken about 2 large potatoes, cut them 1 by 8 along with the skin. Don't forget to nicely scrub your skin free from any dirt. Put that straight into the pan. Give that a generous sprinkling of some olive oil. You can go as rough as possible. You do not need to have any finesse. A generous sprinkling of some sea salt. Not forgetting some beautifully milled black pepper. And finally, a tablespoon of some flat leaf, beautiful parsley. So, this is my version of parsley potatoes. Toss it slightly, and they are going to roast on the lower tray in the oven. The peas going at the bottom tray and the chicken on top. They go in for 40 minutes. Now as the chicken was cooking with the breast side down for nearly 30 minutes, it's time to remove it out and flip it, and this allows the upper part or the breast part of the chicken to get a beautiful crunch. So all I'm going to do is gently turn the breast. What you do is gently flip it and have it in the breast side up, and it goes back into the oven. For the last 10 minutes, so that the breast gets a beautiful golden brown with the skin getting nice and crunchy. Now here we have it, nostalgia coming alive with my mum's beautiful roast chicken. And while this does bring back loads of memory, it also helps me understand the fact how I have actually taken her recipe, basic as it may have seemed, and styled it up with all the essence, making gourmet food so easy. A little bit of the beautiful stuffing, which has absorbed most of the broth from the chicken. Some parts of the mirepoix, which have got a beautiful char. And not forgetting my famed roast potato wedges. While I dig into this and enjoy a much loved lunch, don't forget to hit the like button and do subscribe to my channel for many more tips on how to make gourmet cooking super easy.